Inquisitor? Is there anything I should know?
Repairs to Skyhold's fortifications. We are fortunate Solas knew of this place.
That's all.
Should you
Roderick was sorry before he died.
Did he tell you why he was sorry?
Blood everywhere. Monsters, madness, dying, we're all dying. The head and heads turn, desperate and simple, pure. Voices in the chantry. Years since I'd sung the song and felt it flowing through me. But this is real, this is real. So long since I'd felt it, falling, flying, faith. And I fought him. Maker, forgive me. I hope I did enough. He hates it all because of the darkness behind the door. Some doors should stay shut.
If you're wondering what he's talking about, I think he's referencing House of Leaves.
Can you explain how your mind works?
Yes.
What do you sense when you focus on me?
You're too bright. Like counting birds against the sun. The mark makes you more, but past it, you reach across. Mindful, meaning. You pull it through to this side, make it real here. And past that, the weight of all on you. All the hopes you carry, fears you fight, you are theirs. It must be very hard. I hope I help.
Walk me through the way you help someone.
I start by listening. I hear hurt, feel it fretting. Some you can solve by giving something, food, a blanket, sleep. Some are intangible, terrible tangles that catch on a crack, fixed, festering, and the person makes a pearl of pain. I shake it loose. No pearl, no pain. They can hope, they can heal.
Sometimes you say things that relate to other members of the Inquisition.
They remember me. Their eyes stick, some more. They want me to be. Varric is quiet inside. He pulls me more to hear. Makes me a person. Calls me kid. A friend. Solace, bright and sad. Observes and accepts. Spirit self, seeing the soul, solace, but somehow sorrows.
It must be sad, feeling everyone's pain all the time.
Why?
Isn't it?
No. I help. I find wounds and heal them. I salve, soothe, save. I see pain and make it better. How could I not be happy?
I'll talk to you later.
Probably.
That's one way to put it.
It's made from people.
I'd like to talk about what happened to you before we met.
Before you, Rhys was my friend. He showed me I was wrong to kill the mages. I thought I was helping them. Then he and Evangeline went to Adamant, and I went with them. I was worried Evangeline would hurt Rhys. We found out dangerous things. It scared Seeker Lambert, and he scared the mages. It started the rebellion. Seeker Lambert told me what I was. Rhys couldn't look at me. I ran until I found more Templars. That's all.
What was the spire like when the Mage Rebellion started?
Dead and dying, begging and bloody. Some wanted freedom, some peace, some war. Some wanted it all to stop. Evangeline was a Templar, but she helped Rhys help the others. She set them free. Adrian was a mage, but she killed mages to force the fight. She wanted blood. Rhys just wanted to help, to stop people hurting. Maybe that's why he saw me.
What can you tell me about Rhys?
He was a mage. He saw me when most couldn't. And he remembered. He helped me, and I watched over him. I worried Evangeline would hurt him. She was a Templar, but she didn't like hurting people. When I left, she stayed. Now she watches over him. They should have been with the rebels. Maybe they ran away together instead. Neither of them like killing.
you like, I could use the resources of the Inquisition to locate your friend.
No. If they are alive and safe, they should stay away. The last time he saw me, he didn't want to look at me. He saw a monster. Let him forget.
What did you mean when you said you killed mages?
Some of the mages at the Spire wanted to die. Too sad, too scared, too much. I didn't know what I was. A ghost, I thought. Fading in the fade. When I came to them, they could see me. I used the knife to set them free. When Rhys found out, he made me stop. Made me understand. There were other ways to help. I didn't know.
Sounds like you didn't know what you were doing.
No, I killed people. I knew. I just thought I had to. They were hurting, helpless, haunted. It was all I could do. It was wrong. I was wrong. If I start again, you or Cassandra or Cullen need to kill me.
What can you tell me about Adamant Fortress?
It is old, full of sadness and pain. It should be torn down. The veil is thin. We found a demon there. It had touched a man and made him real again. It scared Rhys and Evangeline. The man wasn't supposed to be real. Then the demon found us. It put me back in the cupboard on the bad day. Rhys and Evangeline saved me.
You said Seeker Lambert told you what you were.
I'm hiding Rhys from him, but he chants words and sees. I won't let you hurt Rhys. My nose explodes, a shower of blood. Just another parasite that's wormed its way into our world, feeding off all the things you can't have. What we found at Adamant made him angry. We were the first rock rolling at the top of a mountain. He had to stop us. He killed so many. He didn't care. Cold, corrupt. So I came and killed him.
If you hated Seeker Lambert, why go to the Seeker Fortress?
Because he was right. I was a demon. I saw demons at Adamant. They put people in the dark, in the old hurts. I didn't want to be that. I heard the old songs of the Templars at Val Royeau and followed them. If I forgot, fought, fell to felling, Templars would kill the demon. I wouldn't hurt anyone again.
I'll talk to you later.
How do you... He teaches them to fight with a secret flaw. Part of a glorious strength.
Jade Empire.
I'd like to talk with you about Templar.
They're heavy with forgotten songs, like Varric. Some of them are too loud. It's hard to stay near them. Cullen is softer, but demons asked questions that hurt him. Evangeline was kinder. I want to explain, but I... Rhys's mother spoke to spirits, but not to him. Then she died for a Templar he loved. Words just bounce off the edges.
What's your general opinion of Templars?
Some like hurting mages. It makes them happy, or less afraid, or... Dreams again. Woke up shaking, stalking the ground for one who looks like her. Always some rule being broken. But not all Templars listen when whispers crawl around inside them. They try to protect people, like Cullen. The good ones remember that mages are people.
Can you tell me more about how the Templars feel to you?
They feel older than they look. They've been changed, and their bodies are incomplete now. The lyrium helps, but their bodies always want to connect to something older, bigger than they are. That's why they block magic. They reach for that other thing, and magic has no room to come in. Like when I listen to Varric.
What about the Red Templars?
Tell me more about how the Red Templars are different.
The Red Lyrium is different, darker, daggers under the skin. It eats you inside until you're nothing. They hear a different song. The song behind the door old whispers want opened. They are dead and dark and done.
I'll talk to you later.
How do you... She hurts, but helping hurts more. She sees the strings that pull me, eyes like raisins in a stale cookie.
I'd like to talk with you about the Inquisition.
I don't understand it. People talk like it's a person, but it's not even a thing. A dagger can be a way to let pain out, but even if it isn't, it's still a dagger. The Inquisition isn't real unless it has something real to make it. It's like a spirit.
I'll talk to you later.
Probably.
Let's see whose Alice is there. Need to talk to Sarah real quick. Do a war table mission. Nope. Sarah, there you are, Sarah.
Something you want?
So you like to have fun. The Inquisition seems an odd fit. Why are you really here?
What do you mean? To help people.
Starting to sound like you're looking for something more.
It is, mostly. Okay, fine, there's talk and I want to see.
See what?
I don't know. I've got all this chanty stuff in my head and it makes sense, right?
But you're talking to someone who's very bitter at the chantry and what they did to Mage, so
I just don't
that's
know
gonna be a bit of a
really
problem.
Know. So I'm selfish. It's all for me. Count yourself lucky, I guess.
I'll be back if I need you.
Go on.
Oh, have you anything else to say?
Can I assist you?
Okay. I don't think there's anything new. The Lady Monteria has ensured our contacts are quick to reply. The few tires on hand. Cool.
What can I do for you? I'm interested in what you told me of yourself and your studies. If you have time, I'd like to hear more.
You continue to surprise me. All right, let us talk. Preferably somewhere more interesting than this.
Ooh. I wish there was an option to spam the Chantry and say Elector Divine. But, actually, save for Vivienne, both Cassandra and Liliana are good choices. And dismantling a institution is a lot harder than it sounds. Trust me on this one. And I think it would cause a lot more problems than it solved. It's just my thing. I'm sorry. Is my mic too close to my mouth? Let me fix that. There we go. Boy, I sure love me some loading times.
Why here? Haven is familiar. It will always be important to you.
We talked about that already.
I sat beside you while you slept, studying the anchor.
How long can it take to look at a mark on my hand?
A magical mark of unknown origin? Tied to a unique breach in the veil? Longer than you might think. I ran every test I could imagine. Searched the Fade, yet found nothing. Cassandra suspected duplicity. She threatened to have me executed as an apostate if I didn't produce results.
Cassandra's like that with everyone.
Yes. You were never going to wake up? How could you? A mortal sent physically through the Fade. I was frustrated, frightened. The spirits I might have consulted had been driven away by the breach. Although I wished to help, I had no faith in Cassandra, or she in me. I was ready to flee.
The breach threatened the whole world. Where did you plan to go?
Someplace far away, where I might research a way to repair the breach before its effects reached me. I never said it was a good plan. I told myself, one more attempt to seal the rifts. I tried and failed. No ordinary magic would affect them. I watched the rifts expand and grow, resigned myself to flee, and then... It seems you hold the key to our salvation. You had sealed it with a gesture. And right then, I felt the whole world change.
For all our sakes, I'm pleased that you stuck around.
As am I. You have fractured rules of man and nature, and you will shatter more before you are done. Visiting me here, even as a mage, it should not have been so easy for you.
What do you mean?
Where do you think we were?
This isn't real.
That's a matter of debate. Probably best discussed after you wake up.
That's an interesting scene. Oh, God. Oh, good. I thought it froze for a second. Okay, who else to talk to? Liliana, right? Yeah, definitely Liliana. Wardrobe, there we go. Close enough. I'll have to pick another time. Oh yeah, still need to talk to, This place is looking more lively. I like it.
Someone emptied a whole bag of turnips into the fire. Ah, oh, Maker, the smell is everywhere. I was gonna use them for dinner.
Sleep well. I've never done anything like that before. Do you regularly talk to people in dreams?
No. Consider that one more rule you have effortlessly broken in your rise to power. I had no idea that the anchor would allow you to dream with such focus. It is truly remarkable. But I am reasonably certain we are awake now. And if you wish to discuss anything, I would enjoy talking.
I'd like to hear more about what you saw in your exploration of the Fade.
I would be happy to share it with you.
Tell me about a spirit you encountered.
I met a friendly spirit who observed the dreams of village girls as love first blossomed in their adolescence. With subtlety, she steered them all to village boys with gentle hearts, who would return their love with gentle kindness. The matchmaker, so I called her. That small village never knew its luck.
Tell me about the old ruins you explored.
I found the ruin of Barandur, a lost Tevinter city buried deep beneath a dead and barren wasteland. Volcanic ash had sealed it tight. In one dark moment, every living creature in the city seared and smothered.
Like Pompeii.
The statues in the ashes. Like a mold made to recall the lost.
Tell me about the old memories you found in the Fae.
I saw a savage human horde go marching toward the battlefront. They sang a soldier's hymn to keep formation. The primal music shook the ground. These savage, unwashed warriors carried harmonies no chantry choirs mastered. Though their cause was all but hopeless, they sang songs that made the spirits weep.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.
Soulless is ridiculously easy to gain approval. Now I found tea. His, the writer that made him, Patrick Weeks, also hates tea. Connection? Probably.
Something wrong with your tea?
It is tea. I detest this stuff. But this morning, I need to shake the dreams from my mind. I may also need a favor.
You just have to ask.
One of my oldest friends has been captured by mages, forced into slavery. I heard the cry for help as I slept.
When your friend was captured, how did he... she...
it.
It?
My friend is a spirit of wisdom. Unlike the spirits clamoring to enter our world through the rifts, it was dwelling quite happily in the Fade. It was summoned against its will, and wants my help to gain its freedom and return to the Fade.
I thought spirits wanted to find their way into this world.
Some do, certainly. Just as many Orlesian peasants wish they could journey to exotic Ravain. But not everyone wants to go to Ravain. My friend is an explorer, seeking lost wisdom and reflecting it. It would happily discuss philosophy with you, but it had no wish to come here physically.
Do you have any idea what the mages want with your friend?
No. It knows a great deal of lore and history, but a mage could learn that simply by speaking to it in the Fade. It is possible that they seek information it does not wish to give, and intend to torture it.
All right, Solas. Any friend of yours, apparently.
Thank you. I got a sense of my friend's location before I awoke. I'll mark it on our map.
If you're gonna talk to me about another settlement, I'm gonna kick your ass.
Hello.
I need to know more about Corypheus.
We spoke of this on our travels to Skyhawk. What more can I tell you? Cassandra and Varric seem more familiar with their adversary.
Oh, I'll take advice from just about anyone right now.
I'm flattered. I claim no secret wisdom, but I will guess as best I can.
I'd like to know more about the orb he carries.
As I said, that must be the means by which he created the breach. I suspect the blast that destroyed the Conclave was more accident than anything, the result of unlocking power that had sought release for ages. What I cannot understand is how he managed to survive such an explosion.
You said that you believe the orb is elven.
I never would have believed a Devinter mage could unlock such a powerful relic. It clearly enhances his abilities, giving him access to power I should never have known.
Like the power to control the Archdemon.
Indirectly, one assumes.
Have you noticed the paintings
nothing
on the wall?
Any law connects my people.
Why
to
the wolves and everything?
Became Archdemons.
What do you think Corypheus will do next?
You shamed him when you destroyed Haven. Spoiled his glorious victory. It would be worse to acknowledge that you had done so. He must continue on his course or show weakness. He will return to his plans to throw Orlais into chaos and then conquer it. The ancient magistars of Devinter received guidance from the old gods. Corypheus commands a false archdemon, a corrupted old god. This suggests he no longer sees himself as their minion. Some of his unique power comes from the corruption of the Blight. The rest may come from the orb he carries.
I'd like to hear more about what you saw in your exploration of the Fade.
I would be happy to share it.
We'll talk.
Now, where are the stairs? We'd really love to wrap this up. Oh yeah, Dorian!
Brilliant, isn't it? One moment you're trying to restore order in a world gone mad. That should be enough for anyone to handle, yes? Then, out of nowhere, an archdemon appears and kicks you in the head. What? You thought this would be easy? No, I was just hoping
you kind of sound like a Yahtzee. You're channeling Yahtzee.
Archdemons like to crush, you know. Can't be helped. Am I speaking too quickly for you?
I was distracted, that's all.
Distracted? By my wit and charm, I have plenty of both.
Today, at least.
Oh, you wound me. I always assumed the Elder One behind the Venatori was a magister. But this is something else completely. In Tevinter, they say the Chantry's tales of magisters starting the Blight are just that. Tales. But here we are. One of those very magisters, a Darkspawn.
Who does the Imperium say started the Blight?
You know how it is. Not us. They say Darkspawn were always there. Magisters and the Blight aren't even related. Is that a surprise? No one wants to admit they shit the bed. But if Corypheus is one of the Magisters who entered the Black City and he's Darkspawn, what other explanation is there?
Why does that make you angry?
Because the Imperium is my home. I knew what I was taught couldn't be the whole truth, but I assumed there had to be a kernel of it, somewhere. But no, it was us all along. We destroyed the world.
And we can...
Last I checked, the Blights hadn't actually destroyed the world.
Not for lack of trying. If they were more clever, they'd have unleashed something that would really do the job. No one will thank me, whatever happens. No one will thank you, either. You know that, yes?
We don't know what will happen. Nobody does.
An optimist! Such a rare breed. I've stumbled upon a unicorn. All I know is this. Corypheus needs to be stopped. Men like him ruined my homeland. I won't stand by and let him ruin the world. Oh, and congratulations on that whole leading the Inquisition thing, by the way.
Thank you.
Here we are again. I'd like to ask you about popular topic. Anything specific?
Corypheus is a figure out of Tevinter history. He was a magister.
Yes, but that was a different time. The Imperium's power was at its peak then. The Civil War had ended. The Magisterium was united, its armies scooping up bits of Thedas like candy. The Magisters who entered the Black City. It was a demonstration of how exceptional Tevinter had become.
But who were they?
No one knows. There's no record of a Magister named Corypheus. All this happened 1400 years ago, before the Blight nearly wiped us out. There are no records. Today, people half believe it's all just a story. That's what I believe.
We have evidence the story is very much real.
But not who Corypheus is, if he even remembers. There used to be families who claimed some of those magisters as their own. That stopped when the Chantry appeared. Then it was shameful, and the families distanced themselves from the tale. All we know is that some men and women entered the Black City looking for the old gods. What did they find? According to Corypheus, nothing. And only he could tell us more.
That's all I wanted to know.
Fair enough.
I should go.
I do rather like watching you leave.
At my ass, maybe.
Here is the request.
Snowballs a second! Oh. Sorry, crashing through things.
I'm sorry.
So am I.
The names of those we lost. You must blame me for this.
Now that you mention it.
But why didn't you see that attack coming?
I didn't know what I was looking for. The Red Templars are like nothing I've seen, and the Venatori hide their tracks well. I keep wondering if I could have done something different. When the first of my lookouts went missing, I pulled the rest back, awaiting more information. If they'd stayed in the field, they could have bought us more time. I was afraid to lose my agents. And instead, we lost Haven.
More likely they would have stayed out there, died, and we would have lost Haven anyway.
You don't know that. Their lives could have bought Haven a small chance. My people know that.
And we wouldn't have gotten this kick-ass castle.
They understand that the Inquisition may call upon them to give their lives.
Our people aren't tools to be used and discarded. Your instincts were right. Their lives matter.
Can we afford such sentimentality? What if Corypheus?
We are better than Corypheus.
At your service, my lord.
The Divine's death hit you hard. How have you been feeling?
Oh, you are referring to my outburst in Haven. I am much better now. Justinia was such a dear friend, and there were so many things going wrong.
Things going wrong? I'm shocked.
I was there when the hero Ferelden defeated the Archdemon. It took a great sacrifice, but it was worth it. We won the day, and I thought the Maker smiled on me. When the Divine requested my help, I went to her. I owed her that much. I sacrificed so much to do the Maker's work. But now, Justinia is dead. I was angry. I felt betrayed. But I shouldn't have let my emotions get the better of me. I'm sorry.
You're okay.
Don't apologize. You were grieving and upset. I understand.
Thank you. Now enough of this. Let us think more pleasant thoughts.
They called you the left hand of...
That they did? What of it?
What is the point of an Inquisition?
Justinia would have started the Inquisition if the Divine Conclave failed to restore peace. She hoped that with enough support, we could challenge the very tenets of the Chantry. She wanted the Chantry to treat the mages fairly. But sometimes I wonder, why stop at mages? The Chantry has committed many injustices. If we're going to change it, why not change the whole thing?
That's something you would support, Paragator. What do you think?
None of this will be possible if we fail.
I'll try not to break anything.
That's good to hear.
I could use the left hand of the Divine at my side out there.
Every agent out in the world is my eyes, my ears, my blade. Wherever my people are, I am also. Coming with you, leaving my post, would blind and bound me. Do you see?
What exactly does the left hand of the Divine do?
Yeah, she said that why not change the whole thing?
And Justinia,
if why not, if I protect, she basically said why not change the whole thing.
To every door. I identified threats and I dealt with them.
Why did Justinia have so many enemies?
There were many who felt she was unfit to be divine. She had a past, a worldly life. Unlike many, she wasn't given to the Chantry as a child.
So she was a bard?
And somehow that made her unworthy. And because they thought she was unworthy, they wished her
harm. Yeah! Bringing elves, dwarves into the Chantry, rather just humans.
You still haven't told me what you did exactly.
I handled difficult situations that couldn't be resolved through more delicate means.
We'll talk more later.
Yes?
Anything I should know?
It seems that the Orlesian army is away. Some of the generals are sympathetic to our cause, others as... Our actions are under a great deal of scrutiny.
I'll leave you to your...
Alright, I think that's about everyone else to talk to, and... What's that on the map? Oh. Colin's out in his new office. I'm gonna check it out. Oh! Shortcut! No legs broken.
Inquisitor, I've found where the Red Templars come from. Theronfall Redoubt. The knights were fed red lyrium until they turned into monsters. Samson took over after their corruption was complete.
How do you know Samson?
He was a Templar in Kirkwall, until he was expelled from the Order. I knew he was an addict, but
this. Red lyrium is nothing like the lyrium given by the Chantry. Its power comes with a terrible madness.
Samson's armor was glowing with this stuff. He'll go mad soon enough.
He seemed clear-eyed at Haven. Even so, a deluded commander is no less worrisome. The Red Templars still require lyrium. If we find their source, we can weaken them and their leader.
I like finding the Red Templars' vulnerabilities before fighting them head-on.
We'll need every advantage against what courses through their veins. Caravans of Red Lyrium are being smuggled along trade roads. Investigating them could lead to where it's being mined. If you confront them, be wary. Anything connected to Samson will be well guarded.
Ugh! Anything more to say?
As leader of the Inquisition, you... There's something I must tell you.
Well, this
You're
seems
ominous. Especially serious today.
I know. Lyrium grants Templars our abilities, but it controls us as well. Those cut off suffer. Some go mad, others die. We have secured a reliable source of lyrium for the Templars here. But I no longer take it.
You stopped?
When I joined the Inquisition. It's been months now.
You've never complained?
Why would I? I chose this. After what happened in Kirkwall, I couldn't. I will not be bound to the Order or that life any longer. Whatever the suffering I accept,
pretty soon, I need to do one more thing after
put the Inquisition
one more thing, one thing or two after this.
Watch me. If my ability to lead is compromised, I will be relieved from duty.
Are you in pain?
I can endure it.
Thank you for telling me. I respect what you're doing.
Thank you, Inquisitor. The Inquisition's army must always take priority. Should anything happen, I will defer to Cassandra's judgment. Was there something you needed?
You and the Red Templar's leader seem to have personal...
When I arrived in Kirkwall, Samson and I shared quarters. He seemed a decent man at first. Knight Commander Meredith later expelled Samson for erratic behavior. He ended up begging on Kirkwall streets. He committed further crimes, but managed to evade the Order's justice. Now Samson serves Corypheus as his loyal general.
Why do you think Samson joined Corypheus?
He had a chronic lyrium addiction. He spent every last coin buying it from local smugglers. Perhaps Corypheus flattered his vanity, gave him purpose as well as lyrium. Perhaps that's all it took.
You can't deny being a general is an improvement to living on the streets.
I'd rather die than kneel to Corypheus. Clearly Samson felt otherwise. I don't understand how he became so powerful. Even with Red Lyrium, Samson's glory days are long behind him. Yes?
Is there anything I should...
I'd gotten used to mages disliking me on principle. Vivienne's views on Templars are surprisingly traditional.
That's all for now.
I'm sure you...
Alright, let's go to the war table, look at a couple operations. Let's bring in the trainers, talk to them, and call it a night, perhaps? Because that was one long-ass stream.
Abandoned when we arrived.
Who named this place Skyhold?
Solus says it changed hands so many times, the original builders can't be traced. I read the House of Army once built a fortress in the vicinity 5 ages ago, but the records are lost.
Let's talk to the trainer, see what they had to say. Okay, Knight Enchanter, Rift, Mage, and, what's the third one? Necromancer! My legs.
Inquisitor, I heard a tapping. My skills are required.
And you are?
Speaker Vios Anaxas. I have come from Navarra as a voice for the dead. Welcome them, and they will serve your cause.
Excuse me. You speak for who?
The dead. Many assume that they have misheard. I am of the Mortalitasi. We tend to those who have passed and revere their lives by honoring them in death. And when the living are threatened, we give the bodies of the dead physical purpose once more. Necromancy, Inquisitor. The dead will serve for you.
What is a Mortalitasi?
We are the caretakers of the Grand Necropolis of Navarra. For the treasured relative, we usher a spirit of the Fade into the void of their mortal form. It honors them both. But when enemies threaten the living, we turn death into a weapon of war instead of merely the result.
You're a mage who manipulates life. How is this not blood magic?
Blood magic consumes life. It tears at the living to manipulate and destroy. It is a cancer among our kind. We honor life. By venerating the dead, we give their mortal form purpose. In combat, perhaps only for a few moments, but that is still more than they had. More than opposing you normally allows.
Tell me why this would best suit me.
It is not for everyone, yet we all reach beyond life. You have already killed many out of necessity. To stop at death is wasteful. Death can make allies of enemies. Death can rend the battle.
That's Dorian's specialty, by the way.
Death can terrify.
People will fear me.
Don't you want to terrify? Fear
like Batman.
Means there are fewer to fight next time. Fear means lives are saved, if that is your concern.
You're saying you can bring the dead back to life?
Of course not. The souls of our departed cross the Fade to be with the Maker. The body is left empty.
Then what is it that you do?
In the Grand Necropolis, we would usher in a displaced spirit of the Fade, eliminating imbalance. But this is war. Every battlefield has one thing in abundance, death. I turn the bodies of enemies into weapons against them. We do not manipulate the living. We make use of the dead.
I'm ready to learn what you know.
Then your journey begins as others end. The steps are small, but vital. There is instruction and veneration. Then you'll return. We shall see what this life holds.
Hello.
Uh-oh.
Hello? Yes? I am waiting for you to complete your task. Hello? Yes? I am waiting for you to... I know how not to die, and I can teach it. It's incredible.
The rifts were triggered by the breach. There's already a school of magic.
A school? No. Yes. Sort of. The holes in the veil flooded us with magic, and that can be used. It changed some rules, modified them, enough that the careless inverted themselves, old forces and new forms. Others will try, their results will vary, but you will have the best instruction. Because your trainer has already taken the risk.
Hello, I am a trainer, so I can teach.
Who charged you with studying?
No. Hello, I am your trainer, and I teach things so you don't have to.
Yes, I did say it.
There we go.
We're proud to help. We are nimble, we could move quickly and commit people to this rift magic. Many people. Their lives made it stable and safe. We're very proud.
You didn't mention your name.
I am your trainer.
That isn't a name.
It is what I am. I try very hard to remember that much. There is so much else to keep in mind. Understand, Inquisitor, that I have learnt it all very quickly, so you do not have to.
Oh my god! I was talking about the nostalgia critic thing, but Jesus.
This would best suit me.
You are the Inquisitor.
And?
You deserve power that casts your enemies aside with the abandon of a creator force, crushes them with your very will. That is the promise. Who better than you? You are the Inquisitor.
Very well. Show me how this should go.
It goes places you have been and some you have not. That is necessary. So the price is not paid twice. Follow the instruction and you will know the way. You'll understand the power. Then I'll show you more. After all, I am your trainer.
I am your trainer. I am your trainer.
Inquisitor.
What do you mean?
I ask your intent. I was summoned to oversee training, and I would know my charge. I am your commander in this matter, Commander Helaine.
Thank you for coming, Commander Helaine.
Commander will suffice, recruit. I teach the skills of the Knight Enchanter. It is a rank. It is a life. Understanding its hierarchy is the first step. You already know this. You were not made Inquisitor and then taught to lead. I will teach you how to rise to your place. How to join your warriors, spectral blade in hand. How to command the ranks while standing beside them. Are you ready?
Commander is a title I associate with human forces.
Knight Enchanter has roots in elven tradition, but it has utility in every tradition. There are no borders for the mage.
Yeah, the arcane warrior from Origin.
There is respect.
Origins,
and there is
sorry.
Fear.
Who granted your rank? What forces have you served with?
I cannot say.
Then how do I know you're capable?
You know, because I have told you, and I will teach you the same authority.
Tell me why this would best suit me.
I cannot. Only you know if you are fit to lead with more than maps. Do you have the mettle to raise a blade in grand melee? To have your presence make heroes of your charges? This is a path for leaders. You tell me if you are worthy.
Worthy enough to carry Thor's hammer?
I'm ready to learn what
I don't know about that.
Then we will begin the simple steps, recruit. And we shall see what heights you reach. You have a task, a simple construction. Go, learn, and return. Soon you will lead from the front. Soon you will command.